Hey, what's up guys? Stefan here. Today, I want to show you 5 super quick ways to improve your Logic Pro X workflow. Number 1, capture record. Okay, so what's capture record about? Well, have you ever had a loop going? You got a beat going and you're just on the keyboard and you're just vibes in. You're just playing, messing about, and you do something crazy and it's like, oh my days, that was amazing. Let me actually record that. But then when it comes to recording it, you actually cannot remember what you even played. I do that all the time. I would just be freestyling and something crazy happens and it's like, I need this in my track, but I don't know what I played. Well, there's a functionality for that. It's called Capture Record. It's probably, for me, one of the best features in Logic, to be honest. What it does, Logic's actually always recording in the background. Okay, but it just doesn't tell you that. And what Capture Record does, it allows you to bring that recording back. So it remembers the last thing you played and you can bring that back into your track. It's flipping amazing. Okay, so that's number 1, Capture Record. You can put that on in your toolbar just by customizing the toolbar, right and click, customize, and you can place that there. Number 2, customizing the pointer tool. Now this is a great one, because what you can actually do now is, depending on where you place your cursor, you can customize it in a way that it will change tool. So at the moment I have it set up so when I go to the corners, it becomes a fade tool. When I go towards the middle, it becomes a marquee tool. And I can show you how to do that. Literally go to your preferences, your general and editing. You just tick these two boxes right here and that's what it will do. And this speeds up your workflow drastically. Number 3, saving presets. Now I think this is something every producer should be doing, or beat maker should be doing, because it helps you just establish a sound. You know, if you create a sound or you find a sound that you like, save it. If you make a little tweak, save it. Because more than likely, you're going to want to come back to that sound at some particular point. If I'm mixing a vocal and I've created a channel strip for a particular artist, I will save that. So every time I come to work with that artist, I have that channel strip already made. And then I can make slight tweaks if I need to. There's no point always starting from scratch if you don't need to. It just takes up time. And number 4, and this comes into place where you forget to save presets. And that's using the media browser. Okay, a lot of people don't know this, but in the media browser, you can access your previous Logic projects, go into them, and then find particular sounds or channel strip settings that you have for those sounds and just import them into your new project. So this is great for when you're working on a track and you're like, oh, I remember that sound I used before in another track, but I can't remember where it was in Logic. Or what settings I tweaked. So instead of coming out of that project, going into the new one, locating it and memorizing where it was saved, you can just go into the media browser, click on that project, find that sound and import it straight into your Logic project. Okay, so that is a good one. I use that all the time as well. And lastly, similar to saving presets, is saving templates. Okay, now this is a vital one as well, because the way Logic is set up, when you first get it, it may not be the way you need it to be set up. For me, I customized the toolbar heavily, and a lot of the project settings I've customized as well. And project settings, they go back to default every time you create a new project. And this is different to preferences, okay? So if you want to save these project settings and your customizations for the way the toolbar looks and so on and so forth, it's good to save those as templates. And also, you want to create different templates for different projects. So if you're recording drums per se, if you're recording vocals, you want to have templates for those so that you can quickly get going. Okay guys, so those are my 5 quick tips on how to improve your Logic Pro X workflow. Hope you picked up something in this video. If you liked, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more videos like this. I've been Stefan, and as always, happy beat making.